Hello friends, how are you? Very good evening to all of you. So just say hi so that I can see who all are active here. And I hope you guys having a great day till now. And you are ready to gain some insights from this webinar that is being arranged by 2T Hub. So just say hi so that I'll be able to know who all are in. Okay. Hi to everyone. Hi Akshay. Hi Rahul. So guys, so I hope all of you are working from home, right? So what is your experience? Just tell me, like, are you used to it working from home, or you are just adapting how to work from home? So what kind of state you are? Just tell me, like, you are used to it or you are adapting to it, because now there are 4 to 5 days we are working from home. So what kind of experience you guys are having? You are learning something new, or you are doing the usual work, or you are used to it, so it's nothing new for you, or you are just adapting to these working from home instances. So just tell me, like, you are used to it. Just say yes, used to it, or I am adapting these things. Okay, fine. That's good. You are adapting to it, because obviously there is a good amount of days ahead where we have to work from home. So obviously we have to manage it in that way, and we have to adapt the things that how we can work from home. Okay, guys. So guys, before I'll proceed further, those who are not aware of me, so I'll give a little bit introduction about me. I am Pranjal Goyal. I'm the host for today's webinar at 2T Hub for you guys. Okay. And I'm around 15 years of experience having in this industry. I'm a technology and business growth consultant. So let me share a little bit about myself. Let me share my screen with you guys so that you can just have a good idea of who I am, why I am giving this webinar, and then we'll further proceed with the today's agenda of the day. Okay, so let me share my screen with you. Okay. So are you able to see my screen, guys? Just say yes. Not, it's just connecting. Okay. So you are here to learn something, right? If you are attending this webinar, I hope you will get some good insights about the business growth, business development, and a lot more stuff. So just say yes if you are able to see my screen now. Say yes or no so that I can just walk through. Yes, that's great. Okay, from my profile, if you can see that I'm a business and technology strategist. I'm the co-founder of two companies. One is VK Roll Solutions Private Limited, which I'm running from last 9+ years. We are serving clients across the globe and providing them the IT solutions for their product and services, whichever they are into. And we are helping them to optimize their system so that they can scale their business to the next level. Apart from that, guys, I'll be we have a platform named as 2T Hub. That is also my organization I co-founded with one of my colleague. So we are running this company or this platform from last 2+ years. And this platform is basically, you can say, serves scholars and business owners. You can say business owners includes your consultant, your corporates, your campus in many ways. So we'll be discussing a little more detail about 2T Hub, what exactly it is. If you can see, like as I saw, I have a which I like Icing Barrel also. Then I work in an MNC from around 8 years. So you can get to know that I am having 10 years of experience. So from where or which background I am coming, right? So mainly my expertise areas is providing the to the startups, to entrepreneurs, to business owners, help them to build technology solutions, integrated systems, so that their business can grow and scale to the next level. Okay, so this is a little bit about me. Okay, if you want to know more about me, you can visit my LinkedIn profile. I am Pranjal Goel. So you can visit my this link and you can get more details about me, what kind of recommendations my clients give to me, what all space I work in, and what all things I'm doing for my clientage. Okay, so this is about me. Now let's move to a little bit about TutiHub platform, because obviously this webinar is organized by TutiHub team. Okay, so just let me share about a little bit about TutiHub first. Okay, just a second. So guys, if you are with me till the end of this session, you are, if you are aspiring business owners, or you are going to start your business, or if you already are running a business, you will get good knowledge once you are done with this webinar. Okay, and in this webinar obviously we are going to cover I'll be going to share 5 pillars of any business. Okay, and today we are going to discuss only 1 pillar as of now, but yes, in the coming webinars we are going to like discuss more about the other pillars also. So I've shared my screen again. So just tell me if you're able to see the TutiHub screen, the platform screen, right? Just say yes once again. It will be helpful for me to like understand that you are able to see the screen again. So just say yes. Okay, Yaksha is saying yes, Rahul is saying yes. That's great. Okay, so guys, this our platform which are serving scholars, corporates, consultant campuses and all. So basically platform is helping students and corporates to collaborate with each other, to like interact with each other, to have the services that is there for each other. And then if you can see, this is our cloud platform, okay, where we are having some like question paper, learning materials, guest papers, online exam. These are for basically obviously for scholars, because learning is one of the most important thing if anybody wants to grow in their career or even in their business. So we have to do a regular day-to-day learning, because learning gives us more insight of what we have to improve and how we have to improve. So we have to keep on learning, because as you guys are here, you are also here for learnings, right? So that will help you to improve yourself on a daily basis. And once you improve yourself, you can take up your career or your business to the next level, right? So you are agreeing to me on this point that learning is very much important. Say yes. Just say yes so that I can see who all agree with me on these points, right? Learning is important on a daily basis, right? That's great. Okay, so like I'll be just talking about a little bit about TutiHub. So you can see that we have a courses sections, we are having recruitment, placement, career new services and all. So there are many things you can visit on this platform, that is www.qthub.com, and you will way. Like you can see a lot of more information about, you can say, your career, or which will help you to grow basically. So this is a very good platform, guys. I suggest you to visit it and just explore all these things. And if you have any more suggestions on which you want us to give insights, we are happy to assist. So, okay. So let me now coming to the today's topic. Okay. So before that, let me first share the screen. Let me change the window so that you can see the presentation of mine. Okay, just a second. Just give me a second. I'll be sharing the screen of the PPT we are going to discuss today, the agenda of today's topic. Okay. Okay, the screen is visible to you guys? Yep. All right, Rakshay. That's great. Okay. So, as I said, basically 2THub is a technology-driven platform for every student, professional, and business owner. It basically works on three concepts, guys. It works on learn, work, and earn methodology. So this covers basically everything, right? So our philosophy is that whenever we have to do something, right? So obviously we have to learn about it. Whether, let's say, you want to grow your business or you have to do the business, then you have to learn about how to do business. What are things are required to do the business, right? Similar applies to if you want to grow in your career, right? So you have to learn about how I can build my career, what all improvements are required in me, which will help me to build my career. So learning is an important aspect. Our ecosystem or our 2THub platform take this concept as their first, you can say, pillar in which learning is very much important. Okay. The second thing is the work. Okay. So obviously, guys, whenever somebody is working, learning for their career or for their business, their main motive is to, you can say, implement on the things so that they can grow, right? Because obviously, when you are learning and you are not adapting or you are not implementing those learnings, then obviously it's of no use, right? So work on the things. Whatever the learnings you are getting, whether you are getting learning from your life, whether you are getting learning from your business, whether you are learning anything, it is required that you can implement all those things by working on your learning. Third concept is earning. That's a tricky part, because everybody wants whatever he has learned and whatever he has worked, right? So obviously, if you have to earn, then obviously you learn the things and then you have to implement on those things so that you can get a good earning. Everybody wants that. That's it. So, but obviously, if I have to earn, then obviously I have to follow the first two principles also, that is learn and work, right? So that's all the three concepts. Basically, the 2THub platform is totally based on all these three concepts, right? Learn, work, and earn. And we like as a 2THub, we welcome really everyone so that they can utilize our platform. They can work on these methodologies which we are providing to audience, or you can say anyone who can adapt these technology career and businesses. Okay, so let's move to today's agenda. Okay, as I said that I'll be talking about the five main pillars. So are you aware of what all five pillars are required when we are talking about the growth of our business? Now you are seeing on your screen. So do you know about these things, or you are just one who will learn from this webinar only? The very first or the very first pillar of any business which will help them to grow is the people or the team, right? So, guys, if you have a good team with you, right, they will help you to grow or scale to any level, because they generally have the mindset with you. And once the team dreams with you, obviously everything can be. So the biggest or the most important pillar, one of the most important pillar of any business to grow to the next is the team or the peoples associated with them, right? Do you agree with me? Do you agree, guys? Just say yes if you agree, or just write I agree, because I think it's helpful for everyone, because those who are just starting their business, they have to consider all these pillars, which we obviously are going to discuss. And those who are have to see that which pillar they are which pillar they basically are strong into, and what all things they need to do so that all these pillars will be strong. Because when all these pillars, then obviously your business is growing in the right direction. Okay. You are not getting bored of what I am sharing, because useful information for you who are business owners or who are going to start their own work, or if you are already running, just say hi again. Right, Yaksha. All right, Rahul. So you are active. That's great. So let's move to the second pillar. Okay. So guys, whenever we complete or a detailed business plan, right? Obviously the planning changes with time as well. But yes, we should have a proper plan in place so that we have the clarity of what we have to do, right? How we have to do, and in what time frame we are planning to achieve on those things. So we should have a solid plan. Obviously, we should have a proper detailed plan, but yes, it should be distributed into a smaller plans also, so that you can achieve that smaller target before you'll move further, right? So the second step or the second pillar of any business which help them is the proper planning. Okay, so that is the second pillar of. So guys, you are not having a systematic process, then obviously you are lacking very much, missing something which will, you can say, stopping and growing your business. So you should have a proper process in place. Then step two, then step three. So everything should be aligned properly, integrated properly, so that third. So all these things needs to be aligned. If I'm talking about process, obviously it talks about the departments you have, you should have a place, and they are interacting with each other via a proper channel. So every business to grow, then they should have a proper processes in place, because without processes, obviously it is difficult to grow our business to the next level. The fourth and the most important thing is the product and the service. So if you, your product or your service is adding value, right? Because value is the main thing that is there when you are running any kind of business. If your product and service are adding audience of yours, then it is the right choice, or it is the right business you are doing. If it is not adding value to the customer, then obviously at some point of time, it is it will stop growing, or it will, you can say, not add any value. So nobody is interested in having the product and the services, right? And the last thing is, or the fifth pillar you can say, is the profit. So everybody is doing business for profits. Nobody is here to sit and take losses and just get down and down. So how you are getting the profits, right? So in all those, or if you are maintaining all those four pillars, so obviously as per my understanding, we obviously generate profits, and profit means more customers, right? More satisfied customers, basically. If you are a side customer, if you are having a regular customer, then obviously your company is going to be in profit or are already in profit. So guys, all these five pillars are very much required if we are going to start a business or if you are already running this business, we have to maintain each and every pillar of our business. We do not avoid any single pillar because it will impact on the growth of any business. Whether you are into services, whether you are into products, whether you are into anything, if you are able to manage all these five pillars in a better way, in an integrated way, then obviously nobody can stop you. Maybe it will take time, but yes, you are not going to stop anywhere. You succeed anyhow if you are able to manage all this, if you are able to sustain all these five pillars, then obviously your business will grow like anything. So today, as I said, that we are not going to discuss in detail about all these five pillars, but yes, we are going to discuss about one thing, the very first pillar of this business model, or you can say requirement of business growth is the people or the team, right? So what kind of team or people we require to build our business, where we are running our business, so what kind of people we should have in our team? Because as I said, that if you have a good team, then it will match up with your vision. They will take your vision or your business each other and can go with a seed. So that's the main or the most important in our business requirement. So what kind of team generally we should have, right? So let me where you came to know what kind of team. Seeing a figure, right? Smart team. And then you are seeing a growth, you can say, graph over there. If you have a smart team, if you have a good people associated, a good client also, and if you have a good team, then obviously your business is growing and growing and growing on this. If you do not have a smart team, if you do not have a good customer, or if you have something in your team, then obviously somewhere you are lacking. Thing will stop you or will take time to grow. So guys, let's see what all things are required, what all things we need to consider when we are building a smart team, which is the very important pillar, as I said, that the very first point, if you can see, is a smart team. If you have a smart team, then obviously your team will help you to grow. So don't think will be the smartest person in your team. You should have the smartest person, their own smartness, because if multiple smart people, you can say, collaborate with each other, build a team, then obviously they want to, right? Which will help them to grow. So we should have smart members, because a person cannot be the expert in everything, right? For let's take an example. I am a business owner, right? I am good in technology, building technology solutions, but I'm not good in marketing, or I'm not good in accounting, or I'm not good in maybe handling people. So obviously I'll be requiring these different, you can say, expertise. So either I'll gain these expertise, or specialties. So obviously I would suggest a second method, right? That means that I should have a smart marketing person. I should have a smart HR person in with me, so that give the best output they can, right? So that's why, and this is an important point to consider when we are hiring or when we are thinking of building a team. Okay, second thing is about trust. Guys, trust is an important factor. It is the trust between your clients, right? So if you are hiring someone, right, and if there is no trust and whatever the person you are hiring, client you are dealing with, then obviously it's not going to work for a longer term. Obviously, guys, it's general like tendency of some smart people that if somebody hires them and give them, that is not going to work for a longer term. So our team should build a trust, we should build a confidence in them, and we'll give those a period of time, right? So that both of you can be comfortable with each other. Both of you guys can align each other, align with the vision of the company or the business we are into, and get a level of trust so that you can give the responsibilities to the other person and they will take on that responsibility as their own and can do the things, whichever the things are required for your business to grow, right? So the trust matters the most, and we should have trusted persons in our team if we are looking for growth. Okay. So I hope the things are like getting entrusted, right? Let's say yes, entrusted. We are getting something if we are into or we are going to business. Just say yes, entrusted or interesting. Okay, that's good. So let's move to the third point. Opinion matters, right? So guys, we are building a team. We are not building a team of people where they do not have any kind of opinions of their own. So that means if they do not have any opinions, they are not thinking at all, right? So we should have those persons in our team, obviously, if not all, but some persons which can have their own opinions also. Because guys, let's take an example. I'm running a company, right? If I am the one who is like having every, you can say, thinking or every brainstorming myself, then obviously I am restricting my vision. I'm restricting to, you can say, openness, because any single person cannot think everything, right? So that's why we should have smart people, smart team members who have their own opinion, right? Obviously, the decision will be based on the discussions between the team, right? But they should have their opinions also. We like generally we have to avoid people who just like work for the sake of that, whatever the boss says, whatever the owner says, we'll say yes to it. They should have their own opinions also, because if they have their own opinions, then obviously multiple are collaborating with each other and building a complete good relationship, which will help in growing the business, right? So think of the persons who have their own opinion as well. They are not the only. Try to hire or having the team which do not have their opinion on anything. They are just blindly following you, because somewhere it will, you can say, restricting your business to grow. Okay, so we should have persons having the their own opinions, because that matters the most, right? Okay, so now coming to the next point, open to learn. Nowadays, everybody is onto home. So I hope you are learning something new every day, because traveling time is saved, right? And you have a bandwidth, I suppose, of thinking about your own. So you are doing some learnings, right? Whether the anywhere, we have to do it. So the fourth point that matters when selecting a team member is the person who are open to learn, right? Because if that's the matter, that's a fact actually. Because if the person is not open for learnings, if they are not looking for new things, if they are not exploring the new things, if then they want to be in a shell, then obviously the growth of that person is not good, right? In the business as well, because business stuff, it is a team effort, right? And if everybody is growing in terms of a major thing is learning, but if you are learning a team, the things are lacking, then obviously the business is not growing to its full potential, whether you are earning profit. But if your team is not growing, if your team members are not growing, if they are not learning, if you are not learning, then so we should have a people in our team who are ready for new challenges, right? The most guys, because as I said, that learning is doesn't matter with what all things you have learned. You have learned a single line, whole paragraph, but learning should be there. we should learn from our day-to-day stuffs, right? So we should have the persons in place because who are open to learn. At the end, it matters, or it both with the learning flows both ways, right? The owners have to learn something, or the team members, and then they can share their knowledge with each other. So for example, right, I'm sitting in front of you guys today, right? So what I'm doing, I'm just sharing my knowledge, right? Whatever I have learned. And based on today's webinar, I'm also learning how to present the things. So learning is an ongoing process. So we should have the team members and that have the quality of learning, that are open to learn, and that are open for new challenges. And the last, and you can see, is the passion. Okay, passion for growth, passion to excel whatever they are doing, whatever the scope of things, they have to be passionate about it. Whether it is a big work, you have to be by yourself also, and you can and drive your team also. Sometimes it happens, obviously, right? But yes, as a team, or as a business to grow, as a team, we have every but yes, then it is delaying in the growth of any business, right? These are 4 to 5 factors when you are like choosing your team member. Okay, and when you are building, just see, you can think of, or what all things needs to be considered when if you already have a team, then how you can incorporate or embed these if they do not have, right? So I hope you get to know that when we are building a business, and the very first pillar of people or team we have to build, then what all points or what all things we need to see in it, so that it will add on the value in your business, and they can help you to grow to the next level. Okay, so now coming to the next slide, what we have, because okay, so coming to the 2T Hub, right? I said that we are into learn, work, and earn concept. So basically, a team can help you in these things also, right? We are basically into three kinds of modeling, if I'll say, apart from the learn one stuff. So we are into three areas where we generally help our clients, our audience, our businesses to build a complete setup, whether they are looking for building a smart team, whether they are looking for implementing the solutions, the integrated solutions, and whether they are looking to market their business. So we are there to cover everything. If you want to do it by yourself, obviously we are sharing our learnings on a regular basis. That's why we have arranged this webinar at 5:30 every day, Monday to Friday. So we are sharing our learnings. If you want to do it yourself, then obviously you can get insights or learning from this webinar. But if you are looking for someone who can help you out, or who can help you building all these, we are there to help you out, guys. And trust me, we do not treat our clients and audience, or you can say scholars even, as a separate entity. We generally work closely with them and help them to grow. Because our business agenda or our business model is to help others to grow, so that you can grow by automatically. Because if you are not helping others to grow, then obviously you are not growing yourself, or you are not growing your business as well. So this is all about in today's session. So let's just let me give you a quick brief about again, so that you can quickly have it noted, that what all five pillars we require for growing our business is the people and the team, the plan, the process, the product and service we are, ability, or the customer satisfaction. Right? At the five pillars, we call it as five P's of business growth. Okay. So at the end, let me share a link with you guys. If you want to connect with us for any kind of help in your business, in your career, then you are most welcome to connect with us. We are surely going to help you out. Let me share the link with you. Right, just a second, let me share the link so that you can connect with us. I'm hoping that you get a good insight of what you have to do when you are building a team, what kind of pillars you are. Okay, so seems like it's not okay. Copy, let me copy it. Get the link. Not to, let me share it again. Just a second, give me a second, guys. Meanwhile, can I have what exactly it is? Okay, so no problem. I think there is some problem in getting the link. Just give me a second again. Let me try it again. Otherwise, I'll share. You can visit TutiHub platform, the business development link. You can go there. You can get the things you are looking for. Okay. Okay. So I am seeing that some people are saying that they are getting a lot of value from this webinar. So that's great, because our main motive is to give value, to add values, or to give learnings to the people who are with us, who wants to associate with us. Whether you also, we have your mail ID, I suppose, when you joined on this webinar, we can mail you that thing. So that's not an issue. I've shared in chat box also. I guess you can see the link now, right? So guys, I hope you get some good insights about like the five pillars which is required for business growth, right? And the first pillar, like how to build your first pillar, that is smart team, right? Which will help you to grow. So stay tuned with our other webinars also, because we generally have different like areas of webinars in which some are career related webinar, which are basically targeting for scholars, in which we generally are sharing, you can say, how you can build up your career, how can you can build up your personality. Then today's webinar, we are into like business development, in which we talked about general stuff, that how can we grow based on what kind of pillars are there, how we can like build our businesses. And the other area is the, you can say, lead generation and marketing stuff. There are lots of learnings on this webinar, and arranging TutiHub webinars is to share our knowledge, our understanding with the audience, and help them to build or grow in their career and business. All right. So guys, you have given your time to us. So it's talking about some business plans, and once we have all these five covered up, guys, just for you, so we'll be moving to the technology stuff, because as I said, I'm a technology person, right? I build systems. So once we have all what, which then we'll be moving deep diving into the technology area, where lots of learnings you are going to get from us, right? So thanks for your time, guys. It's great to you have over here for your time.